are in need of funds here at ABM.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And I hate to keep mentioning it.
Well,
but you know, if everybody gives, we don't have to mention it.
That's the whole point.
You know, and really, when you get down to it, and I hate to say this, but if you don't give, we won't be here.
Absolutely.
This ministry depends 100% on your gifts to ABM.
Amen.
And I know there's been a lot of people that have been very faithful.
Yes.
And we just got through a regular fundraiser through the Arabic shows. Even your brother was on. And now we're going through the English shows. And it's been difficult. But without your help, we literally cannot continue this ministry. We need you to call now, 248-416-1300. Give as you can, as God leads you, so that we can not only continue this ministry, but expand it in this day of ever-increasing threat of Islam and ever-amazing, abysmal ignorance among Western peoples to the nature, threat, and danger of Islam and encroaching Sharia in the West.
The Bible said, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Hosea 4:6.
And we are right now here telling you that help us to keep this country, to hold on to our freedom, that we will not be destroyed. Every person will give towards this new TV station. This is literally like saving America or saving the West from the darkness of Islam, from the slavery of Islam. Mm. 20 years from now, 30 years from now, the most, if Islam continues to grow the way it's growing, if we do not have this TV station, most likely you, your children, for sure, your grandchildren will have to choose between the three options it given in 9:5, chapter 9, verse 5 in the Quran. Be killed, be slave, or to become Muslim. How we can stop that? CNN will not do it. CBS will not do it. Fox will not do it. Even Fox, my favorite channel, which considered to be the only conservative TV station in America, so far, 10 years, they have not quoted one verse from the Quran. If you know of one, please let me know, so I will not be lying next time. But I know for a fact, they will never quote you 9:5 of the Quran. But this TV station, and the new one in English, it will be a light, a voice of truth, a shout from the roof, 24 hours, 365 days a year. And it cannot be done without your support. So give to free America. Give to deliver America from the darkness and the lies and the deception of Islam. They're deceiving our friend, the black brothers and sisters of America. They're taking it to Islam, not only the black. They're deceiving the white. And how many white females in America becoming Muslim because of lack of knowledge? And this TV station is literally the voice will shout from the top of the roof. We don't have political correctness here. We'll tell the truth for what it is. And we'll have no fear for those who take the flesh. We will tell the truth until America be set free. Help us to hold on to our freedom. Amen?
Amen. Brother Osama, we have one more caller.
Sure.
Try to get him. Let's get that next caller right now. Welcome, you're on the air with Jesus or Muhammad. Hello, you're on the air with Jesus or Muhammad.
Hello?
Yes, hello. Go right ahead. You're on the air.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you well, loud and clear. Go right ahead.
That's good, Brother Joseph. I hope you remember me from last time calling you about the first Matthew, where, I don't know if you remember or not, where you told me that Jesus was sent to the whole mankind, right?
Okay, now I'll be glad to discuss that with you now, but first of all, is this on the subject of slavery and Islam?
Well, yeah, not exactly, but I didn't get my question answered last time. I would like for you to...
Oh, you are the one who called with Dr. James White, and your point somehow or another was that Jesus was not sent to Christians. Is that the point you were trying to make?
It's not that I said that. It's what he says.
No.
Okay, just one second, Osama. Let me just ask our Muslim caller to explain himself. Just a moment, please, and then we're going to address it. Now, we know the verse you're talking about. We dealt with it the other night. Dr. James White took some time with you, as well as did I, but you're not satisfied. Now, before we answer, tell us what is it specifically that you're trying to prove, because I don't really understand what it is you want to prove by this as a Muslim. Go ahead and tell us. Here you have millions of people around the world listening to you. I'll give you 2 minutes max. Tell us, what is it you're trying to tell us, and what is the conclusion of whatever it is you want us to believe about this passage in Matthew?
Well, what I would like to know is because Brother James, last time he mentioned, where he said that Jesus said that all the power in the heaven and earth has given unto me, which is not mine. So the Christian claimed that he is God. So if he is God, then who's giving him the power or, you know, in heaven?
Wait a minute, caller. That's not the question that you asked us last time. I'll be glad to deal with that. But once again, don't you want us to answer the previous question, which you said he's not sent to the Christians? Isn't that what you're talking about?
He says he was telling that woman, he tells his disciple, I am not sent but to the lost sheep of house of Israel.
Okay.
I want to know who are they. They're the Jews.
Okay.
So he was only sent for the Jews.
Okay, so what's your point? What's your point then?
My point is that Jesus, the ones that only should be Christians are the Jews, not the Hindus, not the Muslims. Because he says, I'm not sent but to the lost sheep of house of Israel. But later on, in the same gospel, Matthew, he says, all the power in heaven has given unto me. But we know that God Almighty, he knows the future. He knows what will happen. So why was he being racist to this woman from Canaan?
Okay, very good. Now you've had more than 2 minutes. We're going to quickly address you because you're way off topic, and then we're going to have to move on. Thank you, caller, for calling. This is Muslim Caller of the Night with Dr. James White. Now, here's the thing. He's got this issue, and he won't explain himself. Well, Jesus just came to the house of Israel, not to Christians.
You know why he's doing that? You ask him, what is his purpose?
He has no
purpose. You know what the purpose
is? Waste our time.
There's something wrong in the Bible. There's contradiction in the Bible. There's mistakes in the Bible.
Yeah.
My dear brother, I'm sorry, Brother Joseph. I need to give a quick answer
go
and we'll move on.
Because we don't want to waste too much time on this off-topic subject.
The Bible cannot be taken one verse without the rest of the Bible. Jesus came to the house of Israel, and the house of Israel rejected Jesus. For everyone after this accepted Jesus became a part of the house of God. Let me explain this to you.
Yeah.
The Bible said, for God so loved the Jew that he sent his only begotten son, Jesus. Is that what the Bible said? For God so loved the world. Jesus sent his disciple, notice the order, to Jerusalem, Judea, Samaritan, and to the end of the world. Go and make disciples of the whole world, Jesus said. So Jesus came to the Jews. The Jew rejected Jesus. That's not the end of the message of Jesus. Because if that's it, then Peter should not go and talk to Cornelius. Cornelius was not a Jew. Then you should not go to the Samaritan. The Samaritans are not Jew. Then the end of the world. See, you cannot take one verse of the Bible and skip everything else about the Bible. No, the Bible you take as a total. It's one tree. It's a Jewish tree. And we have, as a branches, put into the tree. What do you call the word in English?
Grafted
in the tree. So
Romans
we are dogs.
11.
I know for sure. Egyptians are dogs. Egyptians are pigs. But praise God that he grafted us into the Jew, the tree. Amen? End of story.
Very good. Let me just say quickly, not so much for him, because I don't believe he's a sincere seeker. God can judge his heart, not me. Mm-hmm. But for the millions out there who are listening to this argument and want an answer, very quickly. First of all, when Jesus came to earth, there were no Christians because Christians are those who follow Jesus, and he hadn't yet taught. So he was teaching to the Jews. All of the first Christians were Jews. You're absolutely right. They were Jews, not Christians, because there was no one to bring the message of Christ per se before Jesus.
Yes.
So all of the Christians logically were Jews. Now, the very message that he brings up about this woman from Sychar, Samaria, she comes.
Yeah.
He says he's not supposed to minister to them. But in the very same story, he healed the woman's daughter.
Absolutely.
But he didn't want to record that last. He didn't read that part. He cut the verse
That's
off
halfway.
That's what
Muslims do. They skip the part which is going to prove their argument is empty.
Now, Jesus, while he was on the earth, he did minister almost exclusively to Jews. But he went to that woman. He went to the woman in Samaria at the well.
6 hours walking on foot.
In John chapter 4. Mm-hmm. But then, as we pointed out, go to all the ends of the earth, and he's like, well, if Jesus was God, how is it that God can give him power? If he's a sincere seeker, he would know that if you would read the Bible and not try to make fun of it, that Philippians chapter 2 explains the incarnation of Jesus, mm-hmm. where he, the eternal Word, the eternal Logos, from John chapter 1, the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh, verse 14. He came down, and he voluntarily set aside, as it were, his divine rights and privileges so that he might fulfill the Old Testament law in the model of a Jewish prophet. And he laid down those privileges, not that he stopped being God. He laid down those privileges. He died on the cross because of your sin and mine, for all that would believe upon him. Mm-hmm. And when he overcame death, hell, and the grave, and God the Father resurrected him, he said, all authority in heaven and earth has been given unto me. If you would study the Bible, you would find that in a sense, Satan had authority, in a sense, over the powers of the world.
Amen.
And he won it back by his death, burial, and resurrection.
Amen.
It's very deep theology that is very easy to learn if you will study the Scriptures. Anyone else besides this individual who has a sincere heart, please email us. We'll be glad to point you to those passages.
Amen.
Further. Let's go back to Osama and back to our topic, please, right
this
now.
Historical perspective in the West and in the East as we continue with our presentation.
Yes.
We know this historical fact. In the West, the slavery teaching we have here, it says,
from the very beginning of the Christian church, Christians freed slaves. During the second and third centuries, many tens of thousands of slaves were freed by people who converted to Christ. 2 years after Emperor Constantine legalized Christianity, he imposed the death penalty on those who stole children to bring them up as slaves.
Notice Brother Joseph here.
Yeah.
Notice Brother Joseph. This is 300 years after Christ.
Yeah.
And there is a penalty of death to those who slave children.
Mm.
And the entire church history, we know this fact of many of the people who become Christian has given up their slave and set them free. Just my mind right now, remind me of Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus said what? When he became a Christian, he took the money and he said, I'm going to give how much of my money now to the poor?
Half.
Half. Why? He used to love. He used to steal people. Mm-hmm. That's a change of heart. When Zacchaeus became a Christian, he gave half of his money to the poor after he steal it
that
from
was
everybody.
His, that was his idol.
Okay,
money.
That was,
yeah.
Of course.
Yeah.
And Christian, when the people in the early church become a Christian, what did he do to the slave?
Yeah.
Sets them free.
Freedom slave. Yep.
And let's compare this to what is written in Islam.
Let's take a look.
Ronald C. Gow in Islam's Black Slaves stated that female slaves were required in considerable numbers as singers and dancers, and many were in demand as sexual slaves. The harem of Abdel Rahman contained over 6,000 women, and the one in Cairo had twice as many.
That is what Brother, was his name? He was us.
James White?
No, Brother.
Emery Moss.
He was talking about
this book.
About this book, and this is, by the way, these books are very well known, respected by all scholars. These are not somebody drinking, writing some story.
And yet they're not popular.
Because people don't want to talk about. I wish somebody make a movie about this book.
They need to. They need to.
It has to be done. American people are reading less and watching more videos and movies. So.
You know, I gotta make a point. That movie that was very famous in America, Robin Hood.
Robin
well,
Hood.
Roots, yeah, back from the 70s.
Yeah.
Robin Hood made in the 90s with Kevin Costner,
mm-hmm.
and Morgan Freeman.
Mm-hmm.
Very interesting. The Morgan Freeman is a black Muslim.
Yeah.
And now he's been captured by supposedly the Christians in the Crusade. No, actually no. He was captured by the Muslims in the Crusade long because he was going after one of the Muslim leaders' wives or harem, you know.
Oh.
But how did he get to be a Muslim, black? They don't say that in the movie. They kind of glorify him as more honorable than Kevin Costner, but it is quite accurate that here's these black Muslim servants who were really mercenaries, slaves that were bought, the male slaves from Africa, to fight their wars.
Men.
Yeah, yeah. And so in a sense, Morgan Freeman was very right in that role, because why should Arabs, why should they engage in war when they can go and steal black Africans and make them fight? We can sit and eat dates and drink tea and have lamb and be with our women.